Hello, welcome to Red Men TV. It's Uncensored Match Build-Up Show. Liverpool taking on Newcastle United this weekend. We've got the lads from the Anfield Rap in with us in one of the most sensational crossovers since, I've done this every time we normally do this, since The Critic was on The Simpsons. There you go.
I was going to do the Flintstones Mr. Jetsons.
Mr. Jetsons. I think I might have done that one. So yeah, friends, if you've got any more suggestions for amazing crossovers, let me know in the comments below. Neil, everyone made a big deal out of the, obviously, the Klopp and the Dortmund thing. They call it like the Klopp Classico and all other amazingly cringeworthy hashtags. Rafa coming back, the Rafa derby.
Where I feel a bit sorry for Rafa in this is that Klopp's come to Liverpool and he's come to Liverpool as Liverpool manager, got to be Liverpool manager for, you know, 3 seasons minimum, blah, blah, blah. Rafa, on the 2 occasions he's come, he came with Chelsea, you knew it was the end of season, yeah, and that could be it. Newcastle, he's coming partway through the season. I know Klopp has as well, but it's much further back. He's got a specific job to do and he might not stick around. And it'd be quite nice if Rafa could come, because I'll be dead honest about this. Normally Newcastle can do me head in, but I love how the Newcastle supporters have reacted to Benitez. If he'd have gone to somewhere like Crystal Palace, they'd have been doing all the London media stuff, all the jibes, all the fat Spanish waiter, and be sure we want him. Yeah. Newcastle have gone, what, this fella used to manage Real Madrid, into Milan, European pedigree, won European Cups, he's going to manage us, we love him. Yeah. Brilliant, they're made up. And I sort of wish they were safe. I sort of wish there was the idea that, or they've stayed up and it's next season. And here he is. And he's getting to be Rafa Benitez, Newcastle manager, because he deserves to go to a club where he's adored, where he's worshipped. So it's still a bit weird because, listen, if I was advising Rafa and he still go down, I'd be tempted to say, you know what, mate, it might be worth you giving this 12 months.
Yeah.
I'd be tempted to say, because if you bring them back up, you'll be a hero forever.
Yeah.
You've got so much goodwill, and then if you can get them somewhere on a run or something.
You know, it's right. I was listening to Five Live in the weekend, and we had the Newcastle fan on, and he said, if he keeps us up, he said, if they thought they loved him in Liverpool. That's what he said. If he keeps us up, then, you know.
I think the fear is, because again, I think, you know, we're very rapper biased in this room, let's be honest. We all love the man. And there's a lot of people who don't, but I think the fear for us, and I fear for Rafa Benitez because I do love him so much, and I think he deserves more than I think he's ever been given at any of the clubs he's been at, ultimately.
Including us.
Every single club he's been at has fucked him over. And there probably is a case to go, well, is it the clubs or is it him? But it's definitely
there's some part of Stockholm syndrome on him, because he likes to work for knobhead owners. That's what he does consistently.
If he's not being airbrushed out of championship photos at the end of the season, then he's not chosen the right club.
Just imagine Monts in the kitchen going, are you sure about another one? I've read up on this Mike Ashley.
You could take Swansea, you know. You could take Swansea. I'm just saying, I'm putting it out there. They seem nice. They seem all right. No, not for me.
I think my fear for him is that, because I think I agree, in the best case scenario, it's the second best case scenario after him keeping them up, they do go down to the Championship and he brings them up and he makes himself an absolute hero at Newcastle. But if he doesn't, where the fuck does Benitez go from the Championship?
I think he's in that position anyway. I mean, it's such a funny career, Rafa's, and basically he stayed at Liverpool through too much of the madness, and genuinely believe he stayed at Liverpool through too much of the madness, and he probably would have been, if he was a cynical careerist, he would have jumped, maybe even in 07, forget even the idea of 09, he might even have jumped in 07. And he didn't, and I think he really, and this is where I feel sorry for him, I sort of feel like he sacrificed a lot of his career to fight a battle really internally in Liverpool, to really, that there was issues and that he was prepared to stick it out, because he thought when it all gets resolved, it'll be gravy, or because he thought, he had a responsibility to us as supporters. So I want to see him settle somewhere. I want the idea of, let's imagine we can call this the Rafa Derby, because he's been there for 5 years and won them their first trophy in 50 years.
Yeah.
And then they're coming, and there's a point in the game where you feel as though everyone's singing his name.
Yeah.
Whereas, when we're 3-0 up.
When we're 3-0 up.
Of course. Yeah.
When we're 3-0 up, but they're all right with it because they're sixth. Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
And everyone's just won the FA Cup, and they're still a bit drunk from it.
Yeah.
Even though it was three minutes ago.
Yeah. And I think something like that is what you want for him, because that's sort of what he deserves, because the extent to which, firstly, he's a genius in the way in which very few people in football who get called geniuses actually are. I believe he is a genius. I've said this, if there was a football match on which my life depended between two evenly matched sides in 4 weeks' time, literally my life depends on it. Yeah. Who do you want to be manager? Rafa Benitez, mate. Yeah.
If you're at,
Rafa
you know, Benitez if you had like a Space Jam style moment where you needed to have a team managed against a team of alien conquerors or whatever.
Yeah. With my life Rafa on the line, which by the way is a film and we should pitch it. You've got some cameras in here, let's see what we can do. You know, Rafa Benitez, and that's it for me. And I'd really like
that. But that's sort of why I'm not too worried about it. I know what you're saying, Paul, but I think you think with his career, you can almost imagine. You mentioned Crystal Palace. What you can imagine Crystal Palace going, I'm not sure. But then someone like PSG going, well, do you know what? We always win this league. Who's going to win us the Champions League? That fella. So you can see him in a mad sort of way getting turned down by far lower clubs than the club that eventually kind of plumps for him. So I think he'd be fine either way. But you might just keep them up.
Yeah, it's interesting. We'll come back onto this a little more in a second. I'll do a trivia question. Not for you to answer immediately. We'll have the answer at the end because you might.
It's a bit easy, actually.
It is. But we'll see. Two current Liverpool squad members who've also played for Newcastle United. Not a massively complicated one. I'm going down the Richard and Judy, you say we pay style thing, where you have a question that's so easy.
Have we got just a phone line set up?
Yeah. Just to go, oh, I'm defo winning this style.
Ask Bill Payer's permission.
Yeah.
£2 a month. If you know redmentv.com.
It's dead easy. If it's dead easy, put your answer in the comments below. It's as simple as that. We'll come to that at the end, of course. Chris, is it time for us to rotate again? Everyone's making mention of, we're back to our full strength. We've got our midweek team, which is now our full strength team, and then you've almost got the second stringers for the weekend.
Normally after Merseyside derby midweek, I would say yes, but I don't think they've expended a lot of energy, certainly not in the second half. And Newcastle are going to be bang up for this game. You know, they're fighting a relegation battle. I don't know whether...
Undefeated in two.
undefeated in two, which is great for them. But I think it's time for maybe three changes, something like that. I think, obviously, Hard G. I keep doing it.
Is it Hard G?
Well, we keep getting told. Oh, yeah. I go with an easy. To be honest, I do it both ways. It's like hoopier, hippier. It's like Schmeichel, Schmeichel. I say Schmeichel, Gerrard shouted at me and told me it was Schmeichel. I still say Schmeichel. I'm going to do whatever I fucking want. Thank you very much.
You should hear me say every Sean. Can Sean.
The lad who plays centre mid for Dortmund, Guanen, is the way you should pronounce it.
What?
Gundogan. Guanen is what it's meant to be. I think that's the way in which the Germans say it.
Oh, who's saying that?
Who's saying that?
Not us.
I hope he doesn't come to this country. I can't be having with it.
I still think the best is when we did the film with the Liverpool players last year, and Markovic, and I was like, Lazar, and he went... Doesn't matter. Fair play, best attitude to have. Sorry, but yeah, make it. I think there's definitely space for a few, but not sweeping.
There's got to be a few changes in there, hasn't there? I think, you know, now's the time with the amount of work that Nathaniel Clyne put in on Wednesday and the form that he's been in, covering so much of that wing. I think if Flanagan's fit, maybe Flanagan comes in for him.
Eric, do you know anything about Flanagan?
Absolutely nothing. No.
It's strange.
It's a complete mystery because he was on the bench last weekend, wasn't he? Yeah. Not even in the squad.
Well, the manager seems to have this thing where if you actually look at his bench, has gone back now over the last sort of 6 weeks. One goalkeeper, one centre half, one fullback. So it could be that he's just picking between Brad Smith and Flanagan because every one of his benches had one, obviously the sub goalie, only one centre back. So when, for instance, we're all ringing the last right for Skirtle, he only wants to put one centre back on the bench and one full back every single time. So it could just simply be that when he's making that call, he's going for Smith over Flanagan. But I wonder if he's got him on some sort of intensive fitness programme where he's almost got the attitude of he's already in his pre-season.
Yeah.
And so I'm not even going to throw him in for games at this stage. I want him for next season.
Because to be fair, he looks like Robbie Fowler now.
Yeah, doesn't he? You know when he came on for that testimonial at the end. You're like, oh, you still got the skills, Robbie, but you're looking at
him. You're a player.
He's not shaped like a footballer at the moment.
The thing with Flano is, you know, the Merseyside derby, it's Klopp's first one. He doesn't know which way it's going to go. Do you want to be bringing someone on who could potentially get you a red card? Is that a good idea? So maybe he's left him off the bench there for that. Anyway.
It's definitely an interesting one. It's weird that the only players who really expended energy against Everton were probably the fullback because they had so much space.
Yeah.
How many times they had like an entire pitch to run into? So they've probably like lulled them in there to actually do more work than they needed to. I think you're right. What do you reckon, lads? Do you think is it more a Stoke or is it more a Bournemouth?
I don't think it'll be as extreme as Bournemouth personally. I think. The other two centre halves have got niggles as well, doubts, haven't they? So I think he'll probably pick Lovren and Sacco again. The full backs it might be a shout. He might look to do Smith and Randall, but I think the centre halves he'll keep. I think he'll bring Joe Allen in, and then I think he'll start Sturridge, which counts as changes. But yeah, they're almost part of both squads now, aren't they? Both these squads we've got. So I think if Sturridge starts, and then I think he brings Allen in somewhere, and then after that, I think I'm with you. I don't think you'll mind too much throwing a couple of the lads in there again, because it's Saturday, Thursday, and it's not like a huge. Yeah, I know you've got to think about muscle injuries from two games close together and things like that. But in terms of energy levels, looking to Thursday again, it is a fair chunk.
I think the big question is probably Sturridge, really, isn't it? Because I think when you've got him and Origi to swap in and out, he's asked. Yeah. Whereas all of a sudden, you know, if Sturridge is in the weekend team, well, he's probably going to have to be in the midweek team, isn't he, on the back of it?
I think the big one for the big changes is the Swansea one. So it's the Swansea one and the gap between the two. I think you'd almost go, I'd be making sort of 5 or 6. I think you want to rest Lucas. I think, you know, he's put it in there against Everton.
Bring Kev Stewart in.
And you bring Kev Stewart in for that. So you drop Kev Stewart in, and it's quite straightforward. As
Lucas
I say, you
can, over Milner?
I'd get Milner to go again, and then I wouldn't be playing Milner against Swansea. Because I think that with Lucas, you're not quite sure on his fitness. A few times he can look a bit leggy, and I expect him to start in Villarreal. So I'd probably just trust that Milner, or you could rest Milner, play Kev Stewart, play Allen, play Lallana, have Lallana do this one, maybe rest Coutinho. And I would like, I'd look to keep resting Coutinho.
Yeah.
Because I think as much as the manager's been saying how he's been getting the best out of Sturridge, I actually think these breaks are getting the best out of Coutinho as well. So I'd rest Coutinho. So maybe you pick between Milner and Lallana, you assess it, Sturridge, and then one of Ojo and Ibe.
Yeah.
Is the other one, because I think both deserve, you can make an argument for either of them after the performance against Bournemouth to come back in, and I'd do both fullbacks, and I would always look at, if you can, rest Sacco. Yeah. Because I think Sacco is, of all of
I
our
centre-halves...
I think
you said 6 changes, but I think you've done 9.
And I might do the keeper, you know, if I keep talking. I might do the keeper if I keep talking. No, I think, you know, you'd end up, that's where you'd end up. But with Sacco, I've always had this thing that, you know, you look at him because the way he's built, because he does get muscle injuries. So if you can do it. But I think regardless, Swansea's the one where it's like 11 changes.
Yeah.
And you're going, bang, it's happened. And I think we've got a bit of a problem against Swansea if Origi is out for a bit longer, which is where that's where it does become. Well, someone's got to play centre forward against Swansea.
Firmino,
and
maybe
you just drop Firmino in there and make the best of it, because I think he's also enjoying, I think, the pattern of taking Firmino off on 60-65. I think he's into that, and I think it defines Firmino's game as well, that you almost get the impression Firmino's playing like a lad who knows I'm getting 60-65.
And again, given the situation with Origi as well, it kind of makes sense to keep those two that you've got as fresh as possible to the best of your ability, I suppose. Quick question, just a quick answer from everyone here. Can Rafa save Newcastle, do we think?
I think he can, yeah.
There you go. The full house backing for Rafa. Okay, I want to get
Willie.
Yeah.
I think he will, actually,
that
as well.
I want to do sort of man of the match predictions. We've been doing this over the last few weeks. Not necessarily, mainly picking a player for Liverpool you think is going to be key to any victory on the day.
I'd obviously just go for Sturridge and take it away from everyone else because I'm snide like that. But I think though that the player for whom it's a massive game is whichever of Ojo and Ibe goes with. I suspect he'll pick one, and I think it's a huge game. I think Ibe's performance against Bournemouth, when you watch it back, it felt like one of them where it's a very mature performance. Firstly, he's in midfield and not an attack. He's a bit deeper. Ojo, if it's a bit asymmetrical, Ibe's sitting back here more, Ojo's up here a little bit more, and I thought that's really suited Ibe. But also that what he didn't do was go, I'll show you.
Yeah,
he didn't do all the things that he could have done and being irresponsible. I was really impressed with him. And Ojo, I think on the other side of that is that, you know, he's the sort of player who will give you a moment of, whoa, that's where that's come from. So I think I can steal Sturridge, and I think we probably all agree Sturridge. If Sturridge plays, you expect Sturridge to score, and therefore he'll be a big player for Liverpool. But I think if you knock Sturridge out, whichever of Ojo and Ibe starts, and I don't expect both of them to.
Yeah, I agree with that. In some respects, the eye thing's kind of like it was almost like a pseudo Milner performance in that the Ojo caught the eye, but I've had the more end product on the day. Go on, give what you reckon?
I'll go with Joe Allen then. I think he'll definitely come in, and I think he's been playing so well at the moment, and he seems to be almost the captain of this reserve team in terms of how he carries himself and how he looks to run it. And I think he'll probably have an eye on Thursday. He keeps leaving him out, but you know, I'm sure Joe Allen's still got aspirations of starting on Thursday. If not, he'll get on.
So I think he'll want to sub, John.
Yeah, no, they're quite possibly. So, I think Joe Allen for me.
Okay,
yeah. Right, you've stolen the 3 answers I wanted to give. So I'm gonna try and make a case for Adam Lallana. I think if he starts, it's the type of game where if we'd have had a Yossi Benayoun, he would. steal the show in this type of a game. Yeah. I think that's where Adam Lallana should be for us. You know, when we're playing against teams who are lower down the league, he needs to find himself a little pocket of space and start actually affecting football matches, and that'd be goals and assists.
Yeah.
And I think that against that Newcastle side, he will be looking for 3 points. There might be that type of space for him to work in.
Yeah, there's nothing down for me here, is there? Go Cola. Whichever of the two fullbacks Kev that isn't rested.
Kev Stewart, yeah. Go on.
He's 3-from-3 in the league.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, go ahead. No, yeah. No, I'll go with... No, yeah, go ahead. I'll just go Kev Stewart, him.
why Paul?
Because, yeah.
Because the lad sold you too.
Because you've all picked, because I've basically stitched me up by my own mechanic of me going last, no, Kev, go ahead, I'll go with Kev Stewart, because, and I keep saying this about him, is that he has the potential to save us £5 million or whatever in the summer. He keeps coming in having solid performances, but I'd like him to come in, and this is again, similar to the Lallana thing, he should be able to come in and be really good against Newcastle, because Newcastle are not really good. And if he can't be, you know, he can't have one of his better performances in this game, then I don't know what kind of future holds for him. And also, he will have one eye on the Europa League games, I think, because that Lucas isn't necessarily nailed on for that defensive midfield position. And if Stewart can add a little bit more, let's say that those Olays drop to Stewart with the 5 minutes to go, whatever, and he sticks one in the back of the net, well, all of a sudden, it does change your thinking on him. So yeah.
So vote for who was right in the cards in the top left corner.
Yeah. Neil, score prediction.
I think it's a really hard one, because I think that you can. I think we look in great shape, and I instinctively want to say we're going to win the game. But firstly, there's the Benitez factor. Secondly, at some sort of point, we're gonna just dip.
Yes.
We're gonna have a slight dip at some sort of point. Now, it might be that it's next weekend against Swansea. It might be that it's the weekend after against Watford. We're due a dip. So I still expect us to win the game, but I wouldn't be surprised if we didn't. And again, back to the idea that they need this. They need this more than anything you can conceive of.
Yeah.
But I'll go with 2-1 Liverpool, and it's a very, very nervy last 10, because it wouldn't surprise me if they manage to ratchet themselves up some serious momentum through the game. So maybe we get ahead, they pull one back, and we're a bit on edge towards the last 10 minutes.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I don't think it'll be easy. I think they looked very well organised to me against City. I think this feels like a little bit of a free one, though, with what they've got to come because of what they got against City. So I think if we can get a goal, I think We should be fine, and so we'll go for 2-0 Liverpool.
Okay. I think we're going to buck the trend slightly in that, you know, Neil, you spoke before about us starting slow. I think the lads might have realised something on Wednesday, that if you can get up in the game, you can rest. And I think that it might be an idea to start fast, try and get a couple of goals.
So what an idea.
And then fucking rest for the rest of the game. Yeah. So I think 2-0 Liverpool, but in a different way.
Okay, sound, yeah. I part of me does want, because I want Rafa to do well, a draw wouldn't be the end of it, but I think we're stuck in that weird position now where if we were to lose to Newcastle, it actually takes the pressure off the Swansea game in between the Villarreal ones, because that's pretty much there's less to play for in the league. Whereas if we get a win here, we keep doing what we're doing, all of a sudden you're looking at Swansea thinking, shit, we need to actually fucking go and win this, because if we win this, I'm not saying top four's on, but top five's a very realistic possibility. But now I don't know.
So I think there's too many bodies in the
4-0.
Way. My thing is that it's the points. If you were to say we were fifth rather than seventh, and that there was only really, you know, it was basically catch City or Arsenal.
Yeah.
And my thing with it is at the moment is you've got to not just get past City or Arsenal, you've also got to get past United and West Ham on the way.
Yeah.
So my thing on that is I just sort of have the attitude of, let's just keep what we're doing broadly what we're doing in the league. And yeah, we might just keep getting results because we're well organised, it's a good shape.
Yeah.
So I'm quite relaxed about that. I think the other thing is as well is league position. Let's just win games because it's boss.
Yes.
And almost like all that'll sort itself out. And I think we're getting close to that mentality. If we just keep winning, and that's their business. That's almost like, you know, I don't even want to look at the league table.
Yeah.
That's someone else's job.
Yeah,
ours is just enjoy it.
Completely agree with that. And I think, I think the dip thing's right, is that it's bound to, something's bound to go not quite right at some point between now and the end of the season. If it's going to be it, I'd rather it be this game than pretty much any of the other games between now and the end of the season. So yeah, let us know your score predictions in the comments below. Trivia
what was
answer.
Your score prediction, Paul?
I said it 4-0.
4-0,
I just snuck it in there when no one was really paying attention. Because why not? Let's just keep going. 4 seems to be the new score, doesn't it? Like,
yeah.
Get 4 around.
Let's keep going. Score breaks in the comments below. Trivia answer?
Milner Enrique.
Milner and Enrique, there you go. Yeah, the Milner one.
Milner one took me longer
because I don't think people associate him as much with Newcastle, and Enrique because everyone forgets he exists. Pretty look, if you got that right, then you're fine.
but if you didn't, I don't know.
I don't want to, you know, fill in your own line there. thanks again to the boys from the Anfield Wrap. Go check out the AnfieldWrap.com. Go subscribe to Torpa as well. It is sensational. If you want to see what it's all about, free podcasts on a Monday and a Friday.
Thursday.
Nearly. So close.
It used to be Friday.
Yeah, we've got a YouTube channel as well. We do just very short videos, nothing as slick as this.
So we are going to get them to co-opt and do our one today.
But yeah, a little YouTube videos every lunchtime as well, to, you know, a bit of new stuff there.
Boss, so yeah, go and check that, go and subscribe to that, and we'll see you back here post Newcastle.